Hi, and welcome back to MyExcelOnline.com. Today, we are going to go over how to design a personal finance dashboard. If you want to learn more about Microsoft Excel and Office, join our Academy online course and access more than 1,000 video training tutorials so that you can advance your level and get the promotions, pay raises, or new jobs. The link to join our Academy online course is in the description. To give you an idea of the final product of this personal finance dashboard, we will show you how much money is being spent per month, what the top five expenses are, how close you have come to your budget for each category, and also the monthly expenses by category. We'll also put in these slicers to be able to filter out data when necessary. So here is my Excel spreadsheet with my personal finance data. Over here to the left, I have the last 3 months of how I've spent my money. And over here on the right, I have a list of my categories and what my monthly budget should be. So what I would like to do is create a dashboard where I can quickly see how well I'm doing with my personal finance budgets. So the first thing I'm going to do is go down here to this plus, click it, and add a new sheet. And then I'm going to double click on this sheet and call this dashboard. And then I'm going to click on this and drag to the left so that my dashboard is the first thing I see when I open my Excel spreadsheet. So let's go back to the data tab right here and start creating some pivot tables and other information that we're going to put on our dashboard. So the first thing I would like to do is I would like to insert a pivot table over here and get an idea of what my total expenses are per month. So I'm going to click on L1 and just go up here to insert and go to pivot table. And over here where it says date range, I'm going to hit this up arrow, select A through D, and hit this button again and say OK. And over here, I can't really see the month, but once I click on date, I can see that month automatically appears down here. So I'm going to keep month selected and deselect the date up here. And next I'm going to hit amount. And I can see that the sum of the amount is going to be right here. And I'm going to close this. And one thing I'm noticing here is my pivot table is automatically pulling in any information that is earlier than the date range that I have started with. I don't want to include that data, so I'm going to hit this down arrow and I'm going to deselect the less than 1/1/23 and say okay. Next, I'm going to click here, go up to insert, go over here to the column chart, and select 2D column. Then I'm going to right click on this empty graph, go to select data, hit the up arrow, and select my pivot table. Click this button again and say okay. So now I can see a total for every month. Now you can play around with this and get this to be the way that you would like it to be. But one thing I would like to do is keep my chart selected, go over to design, go to add chart element, go to data labels, and hit center. But I can see that my data labels are black, so they're a little difficult to read. So I'm just going to click on them and then right click and go to format data labels. And then I'm going to go over to text options, click on text fill, and change the color here to white. And close this. And then up here on the title, I'm going to click total, and then I'm just going to type in here and then go by month. And then I'm going to right click this and go to cut, go over here to my dashboard and right click and go to paste. And now my total by month is here. I can make it a little bit bigger, but this is the first part of my personal finance dashboard. If you are liking this video, please give us a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel and hit the bell button to get notified when we release our weekly videos. So next, I'm going to go back to the data tab. And what about looking at the top five ways I spend my money in total? So I'm going to click here and I'm going to go to insert pivot table I'm going to click the up arrow and select this range and hit this button here and say OK. So now I'm going to select category and amount, and I'm going to close this. Then I'm going to hit the down arrow here and go to value filters and go down here to this option called top 10. And instead of saying top 10, I'm going to highlight over the 10 and hit 5 and say OK. And then I don't need a total on here, so I'm going to right click, go to remove grand total. So then if I click here and go up to insert and then click here and select a 2D bar chart, I'm going to right click here and go to select data, click the up arrow and select this pivot table. Click this button and say OK. When I look at this, I can see that this is my top 5, but it's not arranged in descending order. I'm going to highlight the sum of amounts in my pivot table, go up to data, and hit A to Z. And now I can see that my bar graph is displaying the way that I would like it to. So right here, instead of total, I'm going to click once, highlight, and put in top 5 expenses. Next, I'm going to right click and go to cut for the graph, go back to my dashboard, and right click and go to paste. And now I have my top 5 expenses. Next, I'm going to go back to data, and I'm going to insert another pivot table right here. So if I go up to insert and go to pivot table, I'm going to hit the up arrow, select these columns again, click this button and say OK. This time I'm going to select date, let the months be selected, and then deselect date, click my category, and then click my amount. But this time I want my categories over here in the form of my columns. So I'm going to close that. And again, I want to get rid of this less than 1123. So I'm going to click this down arrow, deselect that and say OK. And so now I can see where I've spent all of my money each month. So next I'm going to go up here to insert, and let's insert another column. Right here I'm going to select column. Let's move this over here, and then I'm going to right click, go to select data, hit the up arrow, and select this pivot table. Click this button again and say OK. So now I have a bar chart on how I'm spending my money. I'm going to make this a little bit bigger, click on the chart title, and change this to monthly expenses by category. Right click on this, go to cut, go back to my dashboard, right click, and go to paste. So let's just move the top 5 expenses down here and move the monthly expense by category over here. If I would like more room, I can hit the up arrow here and I can probably fit one more chart into my personal finance dashboard. So let's go back to data and let's just try to look at our monthly data as a comparison between the monthly budget and how much was actually spent towards that budget. So how do we go about doing that? Well, I'm going to take this data that's right here for every category and monthly budget, and I'm going to cut with Control X and just paste that right down here, just so it's in line with the rest of our data on our pivot tables. And I'm just going to delete a few of these columns, right click and go to delete, so I don't have to keep scrolling back and forth. Now right here, I'm going to type in January balance, and then I'm going to put February balance and March balance. And let's create some formulas right here. And what kind of data would I like to track in here? Well, let's think about this first. What I would like to do is take all these January dates under this category in this column and sum up these numbers. So in other words, if this is January and this is the category of close, then I want the January balance to go right here. Same for February, same for March. In order to do that, I need to insert a column right here. So I'm going to highlight this column, right click, and go to insert. And I'm going to call this column month and hit enter. And this is a quick formula called the month formula. So I'm just going to say equals month with a left parenthesis and choose this date and hit enter. But I can see that this is formatted as a date. I'm going to select this whole column, go up here, go to number, and we can get rid of these decimal places. So I'm going to select this cell, and right here you can see this square at the bottom of the rectangle. I'm just going to double click that so it will autofill all my data, and I can see February and I can see March with a 3. So now I can write my formula here. So what I would like to do is equals this amount minus what I just said about taking only the Januaries and the clothing. So in order to get that, I'm going to use a function called sumIFS, and I'm going to do a left parenthesis. And my first argument is, what range do I want to sum? Well, I want to sum right here. And then I'm going to put a comma. And then what is my criteria range? Well, the first one is right here for the category. And then I'm going to put a comma. And then what criteria do I specifically want? Well, for here, I want just what's in this cell. I only want to pull out clothes for this line right here. So I'm going to click this cell. And that's the end of my first sum. But there's also an and. So not only do I want to pull out clothes, but I also want to pull out only January. So I'm going to type a comma. And my second criteria is this month right here. And then I'm just going to do comma one, close my parenthesis, and hit enter. And I can see that I'm left with a balance of 150 because look up here, my close in January, I spent nothing. So this is correct. So again, I want to do the autofill trick where I'm going to double click right here. And let's check these out. If I look at my food, I can see I spent $638 in January, but my budget was $600. So I am over my budget right here with my negative. So this is working correctly. So I'm going to click back in this cell for the January balance and highlight this and hit Control C, hit Escape, and then go into February and hit Control V. And the only criteria I need to change right here is a 2 because this is the month of February, and hit Enter. And then in March, I'm going to click up here in the formula bar and hit Control V to paste and change that 1 to a 3 and hit enter. So if I highlight these two and double click and autofill, let's check these again. If I go back to close, I spent $130 and I could have spent $150. So right here, I did knock over my budget, but in March, I spent $160 and I only had $150, so I did. And let's just spot check one more. Let's spot check the food one. So I had $600 to spend. But if I look up here, I spent $663, so I went over by $63. And over here in March, I was under, so it's a positive. So this is correct, and this is what I want. And you can see that you can add this for April, May, June. If I go back to this formula, you're just changing this number here for the month. Okay, so let's insert our final graph right here. So I'm going to select all my data and go up to insert. And I'm going to go over here to my column charts and just go with a column right here. And if I look closely, I can see on my x-axis the months where I'm going negative and the months where I'm positive. So positive in this case, if you look over here, positive is good. It means I did not go over my budget, but negative is bad because that means I did spend more than I allocated for myself. So if I right click here and go to cut and go back to my dashboard, and I can right click here and go to paste, and then I can make this just a little bit smaller, and I can go up here to the chart title and change this to how close to budget. And in parentheses, I'm going to say positive good. And I just want to reposition that. So the final thing I want to do is I'm going to select any graph and just go up here to insert and go over here to slicer. And I would like to slice my data a couple different ways. First, I'm going to pick months and say, okay. And I can see right here that I have the different months selected. I want to allow for multi-selection. So right now, if I click on a month, you can see the graph is changing just with one month. And these have no data down here. They're grayed out. But if I would like to select more than one month, I need to click this button first, and then I can select more than one month and my graph is changing. But only this graph is changing. If I would like all my graphs to change, all I have to do is right-click on here, go to Report Connections, and select all of my pivot tables and say OK. So now when I select all months, you can see all of my charts are changing, with the exception of this one up here. I can also select this graph and go up to Insert and go to Slicer. And let's say I'd like to just pick Category as well and say OK. So I can now see that I'm able to select all my categories as well as my months. Again, I'm going to right-click on that and go to Report Connections and select the other two pivot tables and say OK. And I can pick the multi-select button right here. And if I select the multi-select, I can select more than one category in each one of my graphs. So you can see that all of my data is changing as I do this. But this isn't changing up here, and that's kind of concerning. So if I go back to data, just by the way, I had to move this pivot table over to its own column because it was interfering with this one. Sometimes that happens with pivot tables. So let's take the data right here where my graph is coming from and go over here to Insert and insert it as a table and make sure this is checked. My table has headers and say OK. And then go up here to Insert and go to Slicer. And I'm going to select Category and say OK. And I'm going to turn on the multi-select, and then I'm going to right-click and go to Cut, go back to my dashboard, and right-click and go to Paste. So let's try deselecting a few of these categories. I'm going to scroll down and get rid of Rent because that's the same every month, and my tech is the same every month as well. But my other categories here vary every month. So if I move this out of the way, I can now see my food is doing okay. My gas seems to be fine. My utilities, they're kind of going over some of the time too. So anything with a bar below the graph is something that I probably need to work on. So hopefully this gives you a good introduction of how to make a personal finance dashboard. There's probably going to be lots of other categories or other metrics that you would like to keep track of. So definitely feel free to experiment with those. And if you find anything good, please leave them in the comments below. If you have any other questions or comments, leave them below as well, and we'll get back to you. Thanks for watching, and see you again next time. If you want to learn more about Microsoft Excel and Office, join our Academy online course and access more than 1,000 video training tutorials so that you can advance your level and get the promotions, pay raises, or new jobs. The link to join our Academy online course is in the description.
If you like this video, subscribe to our YouTube channel. And if you're really serious about advancing your Microsoft Excel skills so you can stand out from the crowd and get the jobs, promotions and pay rises that you deserve, then click up here and join our Academy online course today.